Andrew Tate. Yep. If you haven't heard that name, well, I would say you haven't very much been on the internet, because his face has riddled every single streaming platform I have seen to date. Oh, you probably have seen Andrew Tate say very highly controversial things.
Slap, grab, choke, shut up, bitch.
Statements and sayings that have gotten him quote-unquote canceled. But I believe a lot of what Andrew has to say has actual value. Things that we can use and pick up in our own lives. Now, if I was a big name YouTuber, I'm sure me giving my voice and support to Andrew Tate would probably get me canceled. And again, I'm not saying I necessarily agree with everything Andrew Tate says, but I do feel there are a lot of traits that Andrew Tate possesses that I admire. So that begs me to ask this question. Am I a bad person because I respect a lot of what Andrew Tate says? And again, I say a lot, not everything. Hey, what is up, YouTube? We're back with another video this week, and today we are reacting to Mr. Andrew Tate. I know, very highly controversial, and Andrew Tate is locked up right now, which in my opinion is crazy. I looked at a lot of the case evidence, and I feel like a lot of the charges that he's on are inconclusive, so I'm gonna say it, you can cancel me, free Andrew Tate. Again, I don't necessarily agree with everything he has to say, but a lot of the information he does have to say is important, because I do feel like we can attribute that information to our lives. We can incorporate it in our lives and better ourselves. I recently stumbled upon a video where it talks about Andrew Tate's secret wealth tips. So without further ado, we're just going to dive straight in and really look at what Mr. Tate has to say and see if it is applicable to our lives. See if we can be making money like Mr. Andrew Tate, so we can all get the Bugattis. The Bugatti Chiron is like Mr. Tate.
And I said, well, what color is your Bugatti? Oh, fuck off then.
So, let's dive straight in.
You are either lazy, stupid, or arrogant.
Damn, Andrew. I'm sorry. I'm lazy, stupid, and arrogant. You're right, though.
There's endless business ideas. There's money fucking everywhere.
Money's everywhere. I like that. So, I'll become rich 2023.
Keys, I believe, to making money. First one's perspicacity.
Perspicacity.
Most people go through life and they
I feel like he uses that word a lot.
I've said this before and I want to stick by it because it's so important. You need to pay attention to every single time you spend money, because
that's
you
important.
Cannot make money.
I need to work on that. Sometimes I'll just be going into Walmart and I'll be spending like 70, 80 bucks on stuff. Do I really need that stuff though? But I just be spending it, and I gotta be more careful about what I'm spending my money on.
Is to pay attention to every time someone takes money from you. So next time you buy a coffee, don't just buy the coffee and drink it and think nothing of it like every brokey. Don't do that. Say, okay, why am I buying this coffee? Okay, I want a coffee.
Exactly.
Why am I buying here? Well, this is on my way to work. Is there any competition?
See, this is what I just said, kind of, right?
They sell breakfast. No, they don't sell breakfast. They could probably make some more money there selling breakfast. Anyway, I walk in. There's a long line.
Even from like the smallest things, like buying coffee, you can find ways to optimize and capitalize on those things. You could do better than them. You could do better than that Starbucks that you're buying coffee from. Open your own coffee shop.
Here to talk to her. Think, and then what you'll do is, as you go through life, every time you spend money, is you'll realize the problem is not how to make money. The problem is how much time you have, because there's endless business ideas. There's endless ideas. I walk into a coffee shop, and by the time I've walked out, I already know exactly how to open up next door and outcompete them head to toe. I already have worked out how much is the rent, where are they fucking up, what are they not selling they should be selling, what are they doing good, what are they doing
bad. Find ways
to
do better.
Too hard, I'll wreck them. And I'll send it, and now my network.
Especially if you're an entrepreneur,
a second point network.
And you
send a few messages
want to compete
WhatsApp
with a business. Like, for example, if you want to make it
later,
going back to the coffee shop example, if you want to become
better,
if you want
to
become successful, look at that Starbucks and see what could you improve? What do people like about it, and how can I do better?
Is owned. These are skyscrapers, bro. Billions. Every apartment nowadays is a billion. Million. You drive down a street in London, you're driving past trillions of dollars. There's money everywhere.
There is money everywhere.
When I was broke, I thought that the world was broke. I thought that there was no money. And then I got rich and realized that I was completely and utterly wrong. There's so much money. It's everywhere. If I go to try and buy a plane or a jet, they're always sold out. My yacht is a fucking 6-year waiting list. I want a Bugatti. They launch it. The email comes to my email address. 2 minutes later,
so much money being spent.
There's so much money. If I want a diamond,
especially with him, since he's close, I would say he's at the top of the game.
This stuff. There is so much
so,
money
and especially with him being a brokey in the past, and I'm not laughing at for being broke in the past. I just like the term when he says broke. But when he made it to the top, he's realized like how much the world is different when you're poor versus when you're rich.
All they talk about is ice cream, how to make ice cream, the different flavors, how to store it, how to move it, how to sell it. Even by accident, if you hang around with these people long enough, when someone asks you a question about ice cream, that's what you're gonna know the answer. You're gonna say, you know what? That's because it's pistachio.
Hang around people that are gonna benefit you, that are good for you.
So if you sit in a room full of people who are making a bunch of money, everyone understands this. Your network is your network.
This is exactly what I'm in my. Spend the most time with. I would say last year I had such a big group of friends. I would hang out with them,
because they're dummies.
But they weren't benefiting me. A lot of them were almost like sort of, in a way, dragging me down.
He's so funny when we go.
And that's not a knock on them. It's just that I wasn't compatible with them. I didn't need to be around them. So now I'm only with one or two friends, really. I only got two friends. I'll be genuine about it. I only got two friends. And they are the strongest people in my life. They want to see me win. Hang around people that want to see you win.
Making money.
Because that's what you deserve as a person.
And this is why network is so important.
And
is because it's the same.
Shout out Ben and Morgan, by the way. They're the two people.
If you're a lone animal, you have one set of eyes. But if you're a pack, you're watching every single angle, every single side. Perhaps I might miss something.
I like his analogies too. But one of my perspicacious. See, I'm telling you, he uses that perspicacity word a lot. I feel like I heard a quote that he said from his dad or something. I think that's what probably got that into his vocabulary.
$1 million to get a text message, right? Because I have friends who are paying attention. All of us are paying attention. So your network is super important. Yeah. That's another thing.
Networking is important.
Identify the reason.
Build your circle. Build your circle.
As much money as you want so far.
People that are going to help elevate you. Help build you up.
You are either lazy, stupid, or arrogant.
And you can do the same for them. You know, help build them up too. Be a good person.
The majority of people are not the one they think they are. The majority of people are the one I'm about to say at the end. So let's start with lazy. There are a lot of lazy people. The unfortunate reality about money is
you could change, though. He said there is a lot of lazy people, and I completely agree with that. I feel like, I wouldn't even know if it's lazy. I feel like more complacent. They're too comfortable where they are now. They don't want to become uncomfortable and grow. And that took me a while to realize, too. And now I'm doing things that, you know, I wouldn't necessarily be doing in the past. I'm pushing myself to become better, the best version of myself. And there's things that I do that make me a little bit uncomfortable sometimes, but... Hey, that's life, and I've been growing in such amazing ways. So
this is what you must understand.
It's definitely worth it.
Money. You're competing against people like me. You're competing against billionaires. You're competing
top G.
How did these hedge funds?
I'm competing against the top G.
From the brokies.
Hey, if top G is in jail right now, I got the opportunity to outwork him right now. So I got to step on my game.
This is who you're competing against. So the competition is absolutely fierce.
I love when he says that.
Understanding that you're a man with a small pistol up against a mighty army. If you want to add a little bit of laziness.
I like the mindset of like, hey, it's your time to conquer the world. Step up.
Work hard every day.
Take action. I like that. That puts me in the right mindset.
If I'm awake, I'm working. I'll be driving my Bugatti Chiron through
Dubai. See, I feel like there's also two types of people. There's people that are going to look at this and somehow be offended. Or relax, that he said, like, oh, rest, call them a brokey. And then there's another chill, set of people that are actually motivated and will step up.
Asleep or at work.
I feel like there's always two ways to look at it.
Second I wake up, I check my phone.
And I feel like the same people
between sets I'm working.
Hating on Andrew Tate are picking up points from him that don't, aren't, or just for entertainment. You know what I'm saying? I feel like there's a lot of what he says is for entertainment to captivate you. But there is a great source of information that he gives us that we can apply to our own lives. That's the stuff that we should be focusing on.
That's laziness. Next is stupid. I don't think many people are actually too stupid to be rich. You can be below average IQ and still get very rich.
I agree with that too.
A percentage of people are too dumb to be rich. The slave minds, they'll never be rich because the matrix tries to keep you poor because when you're poor, you can't think. Everything the media tells you is designed to make you poor.
I feel like the media also shifts the narrative in a way. And I feel like we come on, we all see it.
So that's what they want.
Unless you're an NPC in the Matrix, as Andrew Tate would say.
And when it sits there and goes, that's true. That it's literally designed.
That's another thing. I'm glad he brought it up.
Do your A levels.
We should all do our own research. For example, everyone's hating on Andrew Tate. Don't just hate on him because you see someone say something. Do your own research into him. That's what I did. I saw everybody hating on Andrew Tate, and I looked into him myself. I did my own research into him. And again, I don't agree with everything he has to say, but there's a lot of what he says that I agree with. It's important. He has a good message. So do your own research, please.
If you're rich, you won't listen to them. So all of it's a fucking lie. And intrinsically, we all know this, right? When I pull up in one of my dirty cars.
He's very well spoken too. Look at me. I think that's a huge part of his success as well. Ferrari or Bugatti or, and he's very good at like storytelling.
Nobody knows, wow, he went to school.
Using his words correctly to captivate you.
They're thinking he broke the rules because anyone who follows the rules doesn't get shit.
Yo, I'm not gonna lie. When I first saw Andrew Tate like appear on whatever social media platform, I thought, yo, this guy is like shady. I don't know how he got this stuff. He doesn't look like he did something right to get his stuff. But hey, he might have. At the end of the day, he might have. But I feel like, based on what he's saying, I feel like there's a lot of stuff that he's put a lot of hard work into to get what he has.
I will do this. Take time out of my life for free. Somebody at home will
invest in yourself
for free. They will agree with the things that are being
said. And I feel like Andrew Tate is the greatest example of someone investing in themselves.
I'll teach you how to make money online. Nah, I'll do it myself. They're arrogant. They have these egos from knows where because they didn't earn it, and they're just too arrogant to listen to anybody.
Don't, yeah. I became hey, I'll be honest too. I've had an arrogant mindset for a while too. I thought, hey, I know what I'm doing. I don't need
you have to listen.
You to tell me something. But the moment I shut up and listen, even if I didn't necessarily agree with, if I just shut up and listen, and then thought about it.
Even though I already understand, I don't want a car brand or put.
Learned a lot more, and it benefited me a lot more. How than you deal with the currency just being closed-minded and already feeling like I knew everything.
How much it costs for you to send a rocket into space? Like, I'd ask him something that's useful, right?
But so here he's talking about how, like, even if Elon Musk was there, even if he's not interested in rockets or cars, he would still try to learn something because Elon Musk is hella successful. He's one of the richest men in the world.
I want to join that school because, you know,
so even Andrew Tate would be
I sit
humble enough to really
from Luton, who
ask for his help or ask for advice. Because he clearly knows something and if he's at the top.
They answer back. Yeah, but you know, it's not that simple because, you know, the wife gets the kid. Da, 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 and you know what? And I don't like to do things that way. The way I like to work. The way you like to work is why you're fucking broke. So what the fuck are you talking about? You just sat here and wasted 10 minutes of my time. I told you how to take your business of painting and decorating or whatever the fuck you're doing and make a serious amount of money. And now you're telling me the way you like to work? Then stay fucking broke. The fuck you want me to do? What level of arrogance? But this is people. They'll sit with a multimillionaire and tell you their view. Oh, I think that the... No way.
Yeah, too many people won't listen. He's right.
Accept it and learn. So we all do. I'm not going to get... I can't play piano for shit. The piano teacher walked in here and said, this is what you do. And I said, well, I like to move my hands this way. But this is the arrogance people operate. So I'd say 20% of people are lazy, 20 to 25%. A large portion of the world are not lazy. They're actually working exceptionally hard, but they're doing the wrong thing. 5%
are
too stupid.
Yeah.
So say 25%, 5%.
I feel like a lot of people,
70% of people
work really hard, but they allocate
and this is why they are poor.
Their time to the wrong things. Be greater. So that's the end of the video. Again, if you watch this, I hope you didn't take the message that Andrew Tate just calling me a brokey. I hope you looked at this, understand some of the points I said too, and found motivation to better yourself in your life. I feel like that's the greatest thing you could have gotten from this video. And that's my message too. Better yourself, invest in yourself. Become the greatest version of yourself. And again, free Andrew Tate, man. I know I'm going to get backlash. People going to hate me. But free Andrew Tate. again, if you really look in, if you're really curious and you do your own research, look into the case. A lot of this stuff is inconclusive. They don't have him on like actual good. I don't know. I'm not into law, but I did look into it, and I don't. He's not. He shouldn't be indicted on any of any of the charges that he's on. So, yeah, free Andrew Tate. And with that, you know, I'm posting weekly. You guys are crushing it with the support. I see the subs running up. So hit the subscribe button, hit the like button, drop a comment if you like this video, and I'm gonna keep putting up bangers. If you want to see me react to anything, drop it down in the comments, and I'll see y'all next week. I kind of miss it. I was smoking on the weed to keep me tripping. I was abusing on your love to keep me living. Your love was confusing. It had me throwing all types of plays. That ass was moving, had me fucking.